Hello students, today we are going to study fourth lesson, that is nothing but a current, electricity and magnetism. Before that we have watched many of the points, we have studied many of the points. We have studied yesterday the dry cell, the lead cell, lead acid cell, their advantages, what are the advantages that we have studied. Now here today we are going to study another cell, that is nothing but a nickel cadmium cell. So we call this as a nickel cadmium cell because in this cell there is presence of nickel and cadmium. See here, variety of gadgets are available in market. Whenever you see, there is a availability of the variety of gadgets which are required to be carried to different places. Now they can be carried from one place to the another place, that means they can be carried to the different places. Such gadgets use nickel cadmium cell. In such gadgets you can use this nickel cadmium cell, or we can call it as a NICD cells. Now these cells deliver to 1.2 volt potential difference. Now whenever you see about this cell, you can come to know that the potential difference of this cell is nothing but 1.2 volts and it is rechargeable. We can recharge this cell. How much time you want, that much time you can recharge this cell. Therefore it is called as a rechargeable. In this cell, nickel oxide is positive. Whenever you see that, I have told you that this cell is called nickel cadmium cell. Now this Ni represents nickel oxide. Nickel oxide is the positive electrode. In this cell you see that nickel oxide is the positive electrode and cadmium is the negative electrode. Whenever you see that both these are present, both these metals are present, where nickel is present in the form of a nickel oxide and cadmium is present freely. Here nickel oxide is a positive electrode and cadmium acts as a negative electrode. It is always used into the dry cells. Whenever they are used in a dry cell, yesterday we have seen the construction of the dry cell. In that, so nickel cadmium is used as the dry cell and it can be recharged. It can be also recharged. These cells are used in some portable machines. Portable machines means the machines which can be taken from one place to the another place very easily. They are called as a portable machines that run on electricity. These machines run on the electricity, like drilling machine is there, or you can say gardening tool is there. The next point is, see here, the next point is lithium ion cell, which is very useful cell in a modern equipments. Now we have seen for here, if you see, this cell is used in a smartphones. Smartphones which are available nowadays, it is used in a smartphones, then laptops, all these equipments use the lithium ion cell. This cell can be recharged more electrical energy. These cells can be recharged, that means they can be recharged and used again and again. More electrical energy can be stored in this cell. Whenever you see that electric energy can be stored for more time, or you can say whenever we recharge it, it is stored for a more time as compared to that of the nickel cadmium cell. The next point is electrical circuit. Before that, in the last lectures I have told you about the circuit. Circuit contains the connecting wires, the cell, or you can say the plug key or the bulb that we have seen. Now this is nothing but a electric circuit. When a cell holder is a holder in which the cells are held, an electric bulb and plug key are connected by connecting wires. Whenever you see there is a cell holder and there is an electric bulb, see here, this is nothing but a circuit. Here it is a electric bulb and a plug key is here, and they are connected by an connecting wires as shown in the figure. Now this is, and a dry cell is fitted in the holder. Here the dry cell is fitted in the holder. Then the bulb lights up by closing the plug key. Whenever you close this plug key, that means you touch this point to this point, at that time the key will be closed. So what happens? The bulb lights up by closing the plug key. This means that the current flows through it. Whenever the plug key is closed, the current flows through it. So whatever you see here, the circuit and the bulb here lights up. Whenever you see the circuit and the bulb lights up, on the removal of the cell, suppose if you remove the cell, so what happens? The electric current is flowing through the circuit, stops. So whenever you remove the cell, you see that the current flowing through it will be stopped automatically, and the bulb also stops to glow. This type of a connection of an electrical component is called as an electrical circuit. That means the electrical circuit is complete whenever there is a plug key, whenever there is a cell, and whenever there is a bulb, and these are connected by the connecting wires, then only the circuit is complete. The circuit is shown in the figure. Now the cell, whichever we have connected into the circuit, it is shown by the symbol by two dashes. One is long and one is short. Which is long is denoted by positive terminal, and which is short is denoted by a negative terminal. The next we are going to see the connecting cells. These are called as the connecting cells because here one cell is connected to the other cell. Now see here, you might have seen some cells which are connected in the circuit. For here, example, if we see figure number 1, or you can say figure A, where two cells are connected to each other. Here, positive terminal is connected to the negative terminal. You might have seen the cells which are connected in this type, and see here, that is nothing but a figure A. Now, in transistor radio, whenever you see in transistor radio, there are 2 to 3 dry cells are seen to be connected. 2 to 3 dry cells are said to be connected. Now, how these are connected? These are connected in a series. The purpose of doing this is to obtain the potential difference. That means to get the nice potential difference. We are connecting here 2 to 3 dry cells as shown in figure number B. See here, then that of the single cell. Instead of connecting the single cell, we are connecting more cells in a circuit. Therefore, it is possible to obtain the high current. By this, we can get the high current. If the cells are connected in the, as shown in figure B, if we see the cells which are connected in figure B, the same structure we can see in the transistor, where 2 to 3 dry cells are connected in a series. The connection of the cell is known as a battery of a cell. Now whenever you see that these cells are connected to each other, we call them as a battery. factory of a cell. Now in this figure, in the first figure we have seen two cells are connected to each other, where a positive terminal is connected to the negative terminal and the negative terminal is again connected to the positive terminals. Now in transistor, where 2 to 3 or more than that the cells are connected, how it is connected? See, the positive terminal of one cell is connected to the negative terminal of the other cell. Again here the positive terminal of second cell is connected to the negative terminal of the third cell, and this way it is continued. In the series connection, the positive terminal of one cell, that means we can say here the positive terminal of one cell is connected to the negative terminal of the other cell. In this lecture we have seen how the dry cells are connected, then again we have seen nickel cadmium cell, then again gadgets, or you can say the electrical circuit, how they are connected, then again dry cells, how they are connected in a transistor, or you can say in a simple circuit, what is the use of key, how we can use its closing or opening of the key. All these things we have learned today. For tomorrow's lecture we will see the further points.